Okay. I'm Joanne Boyd, and I'm substituting for people in authority here. I'm going to, Linda has gone to get Ronnie. She left him at a visitation up at Beatty's for Mr. Henry, and who graduated from high school with Ronnie. And they're having his visitation tonight. And they'll be here just in, probably by the time the gentleman gets started. I wanted to mention a couple of announcements before the program starts. One is from the years ago, I'll just backtrack and say years ago, one of our presenters here, I'd say 4 or 5 years ago, was Peggy Larney, who is with the Native American program with the North Texas Conference Native American Initiative. And she herself is a full-blood Cherokee, as I recall. Her husband was Larry Larney, who has since passed away, but they were both here at the time and made a presentation about what the North Texas Methodist Conference is doing for Native Americans and doing to attract them into the Methodist form of worship and all that. It was a very interesting program. And she has stayed, and we've kept her on our email list to let her know about our programs. And she frequently has a comment, response, is an email response to some, as she did this time. She was interested in this topic, but unable to be here. But, and this is a picture from the from our North Texas Conference newspaper. North Texas Conference Connection is the name of it. And this is, I brought this a few times before, but it never seemed, I either forgot about it or it didn't seem appropriate at the time. This is the June, July 2015. This is like a year old. But about this time last year, there was an act of repentance to recognize the United Methodist Conference role in Native American pain. And there's a picture of the bishop, of the North Texas Conference Bishop Michael McKee here, accepting a Native American blanket from Dr. David Wilson of the Oklahoma Indian Missionary Conference. And I'll just read the lead sentence before we read the whole story. Let's see, there's also a picture of Velda Turnley of the St. Luke Community United Methodist Church wrote a prayer on a tie that was then attached to a rope. And I'll read this, this lead sentence. The annual conference agenda took a move toward contrition with the act of repentance worship service. The denomination-wide worship service recognizes United Methodism's role in the painful, destructive history of Native Americans. 26 annual conferences, along with North Texas, observed an act of repentance service. That's what that was all about. You know, you've heard, we've had many programs here, you know, that have detailed and demonstrated the fact that this country, from its very beginning up until, some would say still, but certainly until through some fairly recent times, that the early attitude toward even the government, you know, was basically what many of us feel like was more genocide than anything else. Now that's a pretty strong word to use, but there are certain events that that is not too strong that have happened, that that's not too strong a word to use. But and so there are groups like the Native, the North Texas Conference and many other Methodist conferences recognize that and are trying to show repentance for it after all. What can you do when you do something wrong? Well, repent. Repent is really about the only thing that you can do as far as God is concerned. And the other thing was a Peggy Larney, who sent me this email. She said, I appreciate receiving your email about the Native American Fellowship meeting. And she said, the 2016 American Indian Heritage Day in Texas, that is the long name for a specific day, 2016 American Indian Heritage Day in Texas celebration is just around the corner at Lone Star Park in Grand Prairie. I'm attaching a press release and a flyer. And she said, have also, and I'll read you a couple of sentences from that, but she also says, have the fellowship, that's us, say a prayer for me as I prepare for the World Methodist Conference in Houston, August 30 through September 3. I am on a panel and will be speaking about social justice of Native Americans in the United States. I'll be focusing on the United Methodist Conference Repentance, Reconciliation, and Healing of Native Americans. Have a good meeting, Peggy Martin. And here is the press release that she sent. It's headlined, Fourth Annual Celebration, Mothers of Wisdom, American Indian Heritage Day in Texas. And the lead sentence is dated September 24, Dallas, Texas, American Indian Heritage Day in Texas, a 501c3 nonprofit, meaning if you donate to it, it's tax deductible. It is set to host the fourth annual American Indian Heritage Day in Texas event at Lone Star Park in Grand Prairie on Saturday, September 24, from 10 to 3 p.m. This year's celebration, titled Mothers of Wisdom, will focus on the significant contributions of women in American Indian cultures, many often part of matriarchal societies. The organization aims to bring together community members of Dallas and the public alike for this historically unique presentation. And I'll just pass this press release around, and you can either ignore it or scan it and then pass it on to the next person. And if anybody's interested in it, really interested in it and wants to follow up on it, well, you may take it with you, but let everybody have a chance to look at it before you take it. So those are the two announcements. Does anyone else have any announcements you'd like to make?
I have a question.
Turn the camera over there that way.
My question is right before I left the house, I got an email from a friend of mine up in Colorado. She's quite an environmental lady, but she said, please help the Native Americans and sign this petition, but I didn't have time to read it because I was coming here. And it was something about taking some tribal lands away. Taking some tribal lands away from Native Americans that the government wants to do. So if you're interested in that and you don't know about it, if somebody will give me an email, I'll send that copy of that to them.
Yeah, and tell us your name.
Lynn Wheeler, and I live in Mineola.
Lynn Wheeler.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'll give you a card.
If you'll do that, I'll send you an email.
Yeah, I appreciate that.
It's going to come from what looks like a man's name. It's L-E-N. So don't turn it away because it doesn't look like somebody you know.
Okay. So it's a patriarch.
Look at her.
So if you would hand this.
I'll forward that to you so you'll know what it is. Okay. I wish I'd had time to read it to tell you, but I didn't.
Okay. Anyone else have an announcement? No one? Okay. Tonight's program is by Jana, I'm going to guess at the pronunciation, Zabaneh. Okay. And you pronounce it Jana, not Jana.
Yes,
Jana. Okay.
Jana.
And her email also, you have another name.
I'm so confused. It's Geneva.
Geneva. And her card is of the Light and Love Healing Center, Natural Choices to Wellness. And her title of her program tonight is Sixth Sense, requisite, your connection to spirit. I say requisite, but if you take, if those of you who have any experience with scholarly presentations, especially theses and dissertations and things like that, I remember one time Henry Glassy was working on his doctorate at the University of Pennsylvania when I was ever working on a master's program, and he was telling us about his a paper that he had just written. And he did like I just did this one. He said, Sixth Sense, requisite, your connection to spirit. So, Jeanette, you're in charge.
Thank you.
I guess I need to know history. On those plaques, you know, they have waves. So it's kind of an interesting story. on top of that story is my life for 25 years as a Baptist minister's wife, which I am not now. And I have kind of run into different ways. And the Native American way was a very wonderful, pleasant way of understanding life a little bit better for me. Okay, so we need to make places. So we have gotten to, what is the sixth sense? What is it? How can you do it? Well, did you know that God really intended for us to be with Him in a physical, super manner? There's places that you can kind of take this. The Christians believe in the Holy Spirit that is supposed to do what? What's the Holy Spirit's job?
Repeat the question.
What is the Holy Spirit's job in our life?
Well, in a Christian, you're supposed to indwell within each one of us and give us guidance.
Woohoo! Yay! Anybody else want to venture to say what the Holy Spirit does? Almost in every religion, you find that there's some connection to God, to man. And that is because we perceive ourselves as separate. Now, I'm going to tell you the most amazing thing. Our world would totally be different if we did not perceive ourselves as separate. I want you just for 2 minutes now to go with me and pretend like there is no separation on earth between God, man, people, animals, trees, plants, others, that we were all viewed as one. What would happen? Happier place.
Safer.
Safer place. What else?
Healthier.
Healthier. We're all one. We're all wanting each other to succeed. We're all wanting to be with each other in love. We wouldn't have any problems with the Indians or with the black or with the white or with the others, because there are no others. There are no others. So we can attach every problem in the whole entire world to the word separation. One word. So I am here to connect you to the spirit of oneness, whatever you can see Him to be. Because if I ask each person what their idea of God and their religion or spiritualism or value system, every one of y'all will give me a different answer. There's not one person in here that has my total belief system in you. You might have parts of it. You might believe some of the things I believe, but you don't have all of it. So I'm going to connect you to what I consider spirit. Okay. How many people know that this world is a binary, that's a binary world? You know what binary is? It's a, yes.
Two.
How many?
Two.
Binary.
Two.
And so, does anybody know computer? Okay, bye.
It's built on a binary system.
Computers are binary systems. They only speak two words. Yes, no. Off, on, negative, positive.
Ching-chang.
Uh-huh. Okay, so that system is not only computerized, a computer system, it's also a universal language that God has given us, or Spirit has given us. So we can have the answer to our truth anytime we want. This is where you'll go, oh my gosh! The answer to all questions
Okay. I don't understand binary.
Right. I know. We're gonna talk about the binary code.
A spirit
that's gonna teach us yes and no, the whole of any question that we ever needed or wanted to know, we can have it. If I was selling this, how many people would be interested to know your truth of any question that you wanted to know? Just raise your hand.
If we thought that was possible,
uh-huh.
Sure, you'd want to buy it.
Okay. How many? Is there other people that would not want to know the answer to any question that they have? You're the only one, Leah.
I'm not sure I understand the
okay,
the question.
If you could know,
if I could know
the answer
to everything,
to your truth, to any question that you wanted to be answered, would you want to know? Would you want to know the truth?
Sure. That's what we search for.
I thought that's what we were doing.
Okay. So you would buy in?
Ooh. Yeah.
Would you want to know the truth? Okay, there's some takers. There's a couple of takers.
I guess I have a skepticism about knowing, well, one, that there is a truth.
Right. Okay.
An absolute.
Okay, this is your trick. This is not my trick. This is your trick. I'm saying that you can have knowledge.
What I'm saying is I couldn't buy into the idea.
Okay, well, we're sitting on the line.
So I'm way back.
I know, but that's great. Because that's a little challenging.
No, I'm not really straggling.
No. you can sit there because that's a good challenge. That's my challenge. Okay.
Since you're getting so many different reactions, I'll just point out to you, and maybe you want to comment in some way how it relates to your question, is in the New Testament, Jesus tells Pilate that he is seeking the truth and telling the truth, and Pilate says, famously, "What is truth?" Johnny Cash wrote a song with that title. So how would you answer Pilate's question, "What is truth?"
Truth, from your point of view, and I'm not talking about everybody's truth, I'm talking about having the knowledge of spirit within you that gives you a yes-no answer to any question that you want to know.
We can already do that with Google.
I came a little too late. Oh, I'll be back later. So, what I'm going to teach you now is universal, I call it universal knowledge, but it's my trick. So, what you do is you kind of center yourself in a place, I'm going to put my phone out so I don't feel centered, and I'm going to ask a question, and I'm going to show you what happens. Am I a girl? Did y'all see that? Okay, I'll do it again. Am I a girl? Am I a boy? No. Okay, so that's my yes. This yes goes forward and pulls me slightly up, and no pushes me backwards and slightly down. Okay. Now, we have establish that. Am I in Gilmer? No. Am I speaking in Winsboro? To think about it. That was a hard question. There it goes. Okay, yes. Okay. So, what we're going to do is now test out universal knowledge and see if you can actually feel yes, no. Okay, so if y'all will stand up, please. You don't have to stand up if you don't need to. But what you can do, if you just scoot up just a tad bit when you're not up against the back of that chair,
sit up straight.
So, So, we're standing up, and are you a girl? Are you a boy? Did you feel it?
I know she did. I saw her standing up.
Did you?
I know how to muscle test.
So. Oh, expert here.
I know what you're doing. So.
Okay. So
I,
you.
I use this method.
Yeah.
Okay. You're using the sway test.
Right. Sway test.
Yeah.
Okay. So. And a lot of people do this. Chiropractors, doctors, people that just want to know. This it's practical for almost anything. Okay, so did you feel it? Okay. Is your name Alice?
You did? I didn't feel it.
Because there's a really wonderful, super duper thing in your ear that's called inner ear balance, and it's in your thigh.
You are in control. Yeah.
And I'm just teaching you a great way of treating that. Okay, so did you feel anything? No? Okay.
I already know the answers. I mean, I don't know what I'm...
This is not thinking. This is your body trying to communicate.
No, I know answers, but okay. You're not.
What can I ask that would be? Okay. So anyway.
Put your hands to your sides.
Put your hands. Yeah.
There you go.
And
just take a deep breath.
Is ice cream good for you?
My mind automatically.
Yeah. Does. Think about it. Sometimes ice cream is
And the answer
really
is supposed to come to me through my body?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Just your, and I'm asking your body. Is ice cream good for you?
I'm sorry, I don't have an ice cream.
Okay, I see it. Okay.
She did do it.
I did, I see it. Okay.
I bet if I stood here long enough, I'd go on.
Yeah,
something. But I can't tell you that was the end.
Okay, so we've kind of proven, y'all can sit down now. We've kind of proven that there is this gigantic elephant in this room called energy. And the energy is a universal language based on a binary, a dualistic code, yes and no. Okay, so now what do we do with it? What would you do with the knowledge that you could to test anything or ask any question and know the answer to it? What do you do with yours? What do you test?
What do I test?
Uh-huh.
I'll ask questions like, if I'm working with one of my animals, I'll ask them if there's, like right now, we're going through a grieving process, and so I'm trying to find out what the animal is wanting. And but like what she was teaching you, if you're in a grocery store, or if you're in a health food store, and you've got all of these vitamins and things in front of you, and say you're looking for magnesium, let's say, and you can just ask your body, you just stand in front of all of the magnesiums, and you ask your body, you can focus on one and say, is this the one that's good for my body? And you will sway yes, or you'll sway no.
Okay.
So if you're can't decide what you want to eat, you can ask your body, do you want chicken salad for lunch, or do you want taco salad, you know? And you'll get a yes or no answer to that. So, because sometimes your body, sometimes our mind thinks we want something, but your body wants something else. So it's a way of connecting, using our body as a pendulum, basically, as a divination tool, to get answers from our bodies, because God has given to to interact with one another and to get information from our bodies and from anything else.
Thank you. So I use it all the time. It at first it was kind of like, oh, what am I going to do with this? And so I just tested supplements. I only tested like food. I went to the grocery store and picked out the apple that I really felt. But now I don't ever turn it off. My sixth sense is on all the time, and it collects data. It collects thousands and thousands of supplements. It collects many, many different things to help people that come to be healed at the healing center. Let me just show you that you can test someone else. Can I use you, sir? Okay. I am going to just hold your arm out like this. And can you hold it up for me? Hold your arm up.
He's had a stroke. Okay. He's had a stroke.
Is this the good arm?
I don't know. Is that your good arm?
Good arm. Okay, so I'm just going to push lightly on it. I'm going to say yes. And it's testing strong. This is his nose. So you can just see that just by, I'm not shoving it, but just by touching it, this is his nose. So that you can test it. Thank you so much. Thank you. I appreciate it. You can test any muscle in your body. There's many ways to do it. You did the...
I did this.
Oh, this. Okay. No. Yeah. Okay. This is yes. It feels hard. Yeah. Try that. Try it. A little circle. And then push in and say yes. 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 And feel how strong that feels. Now say no. No. Can you feel how...
It should. Still supposed to be doing the same thing for yes or no, but we feel the difference?
Right.
Oh.
So we're going to do yes. And to me, it just feels strong, and it's completely up against the circle. Okay, no. Now push. No. Do you feel something different?
Okay, when I get a no, mine actually just pop open.
Yeah.
That's my no.
Yeah.
But it just takes practice.
Right. Okay, there's lots and lots of different ways of doing this. My favorite one is this one. You hold this finger straight and hard. Okay, everybody gets a finger out. And this one's hard. And then you're going to put this one, you're going to push against it. Push hard, yes. Push hard. Do you feel how hard that is? Right? Okay, now say no. Say no. Push against it. But what does it feel like? It's weak. So it goes weak. The muscle goes weak. Now the principle of all this is that God intended us to have bounty and beauty and awesomeness in our life. He wanted us to have everything good. Everything perfect. Life is not like that. And a whole bunch of other things. There was a snake in the grass, and then a serpent, and then there was too many things out there. Anyway, but God truly wanted us to have the stuff that's really great for us. So, really, if you look back only 100 years ago or so, you find that native people in their natural environment knew things that you wouldn't know. That they had this feeling of how to get food and survive, what was poisonous, what was not poisonous, what's good to eat, how to do things. And it was, they said, a gut feeling, an errant feeling where, you know, you just kind of know that something is there. So that's what it's kind of, it evolved from that to being part of a really amazing science. Okay, so my first little thing to show you, if y'all are interested in this at all, David Hawkins wrote Power versus Force, and in this it tells you all about muscle testing and understanding this power. And the power is that we can, is love. is love. Force is anything else. And you can see that. Sometimes we call it ugly words like bad or evil, but it's just force instead of having power. And so that's a real good reference if you want to use that sometimes. But we are just about to go into our first activity of actually testing substances that might be good for your body. But this is commercial break. Woo-hoo! Okay, commercial break. First commercial break. Yes. Let's see, I brought three commercial breaks. Okay. First commercial break. I'm not selling this stuff. But Sammy is probably one of my best little secrets in the world. How many people have arthritis? Rheumatism, aches and pains, joint stiffness. Okay. I almost got everybody. But how many people have mild depression sometimes? How many people have congestion of your liver that really needs to be addressed? Oh, well. Okay. So, this is Sammy. They used this back in the 1930s, 40s. It was a new substance. It's found naturally in your body. And they used it. They found it. And so they tested it out in asylums. And they found that this stuff was really great. It cured mild to moderate depression. But people were waking up with this amazing side effect. Their arthritis, stiff bones, and muscles were feeling awesome. They felt good, their body felt good, and their liver detoxed, which really helped them, like, exponentially. So anyway, so let's all say thank you for the first commercial.
Thank you.
Yay! Now we return to the regular scheduled program. I do have notes. I don't need notes. Okay, so y'all are okay with this being like we can do some activities, right? Because long time ago, when the teacher said, "Oh, let's do an activity," y'all go, "Oh my gosh, it was so much fun!" Okay, so what we're gonna do? Does everybody have pens and pencils? Oh, gosh darn. I didn't think about that. Whoops.
We're in a church. Somebody should have some pens somewhere.
And then we have these lovely little pads. Look how cute they are.
I've already been writing on mine.
Okay. And I forgot that we had to have pens. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to practice muscle testing. Six cents in these little cups. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to pass them around. And what you're going to do, you can just actually sit down and do this. When you're sitting down and doing this, okay, we can actually just do it like this. Don't put your back against the chair because then you won't go anywhere. But you can go. Is this supplement good for the health or healing of my body? I don't have to say that much. Is this good for me? Remember that sometimes your body needs to be. And I'm giving you. So I don't need number three. Let's see. I don't find one of this, yes. This one right here. Okay. Is this supplement good for me? This is interesting because I'm just feeling a downward motion. I'm not feeling a yes. I'm just kind of feeling a downward. Yes? Okay. I'm pretty... I don't need any of this. So, but anyway, some of y'all might. So, if y'all want to stand up, that's fine. We're done. Oh, good. Thank you, sweetie. That was wonderful. Okay. So, what we're going to do is I am going to start with this and I think we're all in the room. Okay. So what we're going to do is we're going to take an active learning break. Does anybody need to get up and walk around? Are y'all are okay? Kids, you know, after 20 minutes of talking, they need to kind of get up and do something. If you do, that's fine. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to, I'm going to start these over here, and I'm just going to, you take one and then pass them all the way around. We don't have to do all of them. And then y'all can take some and...
I think, did this come out of here?
Oh, it did.
Let me see if I can get it.
Uh-huh. Okay. So, and then y'all can take these and see what you do. So you're just going to take one.
This is a good one. It's fine.
Yeah. Huh? Yes.
Sorry.
Yes. Chiropractor used to do this.
And then what do we do? Put write something down?
Whatever.
So there you go. That's right.
Now,
take one and put it to your heart and ask your body, is this good for me?
So what do we do with our pencil paper?
This is if you actually need one, write it down.
Write down the number.
Right.
Oh.
Because I'm going to give you the answers in just a minute.
Here, hold on.
Okay, so universal knowledge has no interest for Sandra, but that's okay. You might need it someday.
I'm sorry.
Look at this. It's a little bit long. Okay. I mean, has anybody ever, thought about this? I mean, it's a new thought. And I give yourself credit for having new thoughts today. They're very rare. New thoughts are rare.
I said the thing when the chiropractor would do this.
Uh-huh.
I didn't know what kind of answer he was looking for.
You don't need one.
And so he was, and then he didn't think I needed to know. So he said, no, you don't need that. And you pick up and go, no, you're all
right.
Okay, yeah, you need that.
Right.
But I didn't know how he knew. How
right. Because he was reading your body.
Yeah.
But I didn't know. Right. Right. And he didn't stop and teach you.
Oh, I think he was there.
But if I teach you, if I teach one person today,
answer.
Six
cents. Feel like, if something makes you feel like you need it, you write the number.
There might be a whole generation of people out there.
Everybody's supposed to tell you.
That don't go to the doctor. They don't go to the doctor. They don't go places to get advice from people because they have.
You didn't have to be right on your heart, honey. Just anywhere, any close.
Yeah,
just put it on your chest.
Will you pick it up?
Don't take your blouse off.
Can if you want to. But
okay. So did you find any?
No, we both tested negative.
Okay, so keep passing. Pass. Pass. All the things. Pass
them
around. Nope. Didn't make any difference whatsoever. You can. It doesn't. If you do it right handed, left handed, that's great.
This is one that came from the other side. Did you pass this? I just. You've already done this, right?
You need that one.
Actually, you don't even have to have a substance in it. You can just look at the list and figure out. Did any of you find
it?
Did you find any? I'm
not. I'm just going to
hold mine.
Okay. Oh, palm. It should be.
Yeah. I mean, you could literally look at
my body.
It can be literally sitting on a shelf. You don't have to have it physically in your hand. Because you can just ask, is this good for me? But you have two substances in your hands, so you're going to get confusing answers. You've got to do one at a time.
Your right hand doesn't know what the right hand's doing.
If you say, is the thing in my left hand good for me, then it must. But if you say, is this good for me, then it's going to go.
You may not get an answer.
You may not get an answer for this.
Okay. So you're sitting back, too, so your body's not able to sway either way.
Let me give you some practical things about body level testing. If you go to the drugstore and you're coughing your head off and you look at the cough section and there's 79 cough syrups, what you can do, you don't have to pick up each one, you can just point to it or touch it, you know, and let your eyes hang off the whole thing. I know this is the 79 things that I might need, and I want you, body, to pick out one of these that will benefit me the most. Okay, so I'm asking my body to find the one that is the best for me. So I can go through and test it and see, oh, those are all no's, all no's, all no's, all no's. And right here, it got strong. So I look at that cough medicine, I think, okay, this is the one. Is there anything else? No. Is there anything better? No. Is this the right one? So I put it here. Is it good for me? Yes. So that way I've made the best choice. Because there's so many choices out there, guys, now. You know, used to there used to not be. It was lemon and honey and mental store
now just to pick out toothpaste.
Which one?
The curacone and iodine. Castor oil we grew up on.
Absolutely. Okay. So did everybody find at least one thing that you need?
We found one for Ronnie.
Okay. Good, good, good. Super. Okay. So now
you got one.
I have my cheat sheets. Whoops. And I'll just pass that down. Eight. You need one or eight. Okay. So you can kind of look and see.
She had one.
Okay. Did you ever find one?
Nope.
It's good. Does that mean that you're kind of healthy?
That means I'm really healthy, doesn't it?
Absolutely.
I take half of these probably.
Okay.
There's yours.
And let me see if I can.
That's what you need.
Did you find one?
That's what that says.
Okay.
I'll just use hers. Let me see what it says.
Well,
there you go.
Mm-hmm.
With chlorophyll.
Okay,
everybody
so,
has chlorophyll.
As wonderful as all these supplements are, I'm a big fan of food. Big fan of food. Love food. So, can you think of something that has vitamin C in it?
Oranges.
Good. Immune support. What is a good thing to take for me?
Garlic.
Woohoo! Garlic. Excellent. Garlic is probably one of the best. I mean, it's 300 times more potent than what's the pink antibiotic stuff? Ooh, whatever that is, I forgot. Okay, what can you do for your joints? Joint mobility. Mm-hmm. What's good for you?
MSM.
MSM, conjointing. Yes, NSAIDs are good if you're in pain.
What about the, you had it down here, at number 17, glucosamine is good for joints.
Yeah, it is. And Boswell, all of those are.
I don't know the food for it.
Yeah, that's kind of hard, but like bone broth, extra broth.
Usually with joints, like with arthritis, you want to avoid things like peppers, bell peppers, and things
shakes.
Like that. But capsaicin is really good for joint pain.
Uh-huh.
Nightshades, yeah. Avoid nightshades.
Two of those, potatoes and tomatoes.
Eggplant. Yeah.
Malic relief improves muscle function. Can y'all think of anything for muscles? My favorite go-to is, oh, it's already on here, so I'll just skip down to it. Calcium. We know that we need to drink milk or substitute milk, or even green leafy vegetables have calcium, right? Okay.
Yes.
Enzymes. Number seven. Great carbs have. Enzymes are... gosh, how would you do that?
I don't know.
I don't either. Get an enzyme. For your skin, all these wonderful things. Blue green algae, superfoods. How many people supplement their diet with just really great vitamins that come from real food? Like tomatoes and spinach and blue green algae, those kind of things.
Kale.
Stinging.
Yes, thank you.
It's good for arthritis.
Allergies too.
Like, I keep dried cranberries in the house all the time because you just can't keep them around.
Right.
And, of course, it's a higher sugar content for the same volume, but it's not like you're adding sugar.
It's not like it has cut sugar.
But you can take fresh cranberries and throw the whole bag in the freezer.
Yeah.
Like I do blueberries.
Right.
Okay. Thank you.
Proteins, red blood cells, you get iron, all this kind of stuff, RNA and DNA complex, that's kind of hard. So my favorite for sore muscles is L-glutamine. Anytime that you're going to go work outside or paint a house or do something that's strenuous or go to the gym, I don't mind working out. I don't mind doing work. But I do not want to be sore for the next 3 days. If you take, I usually take 6 to 8 glutamines before I do the work, and 6 to 8 glutamines after I do the work, and the next day I think, oh, sure is nice waking up without any pain. So that's just something that's good. Caprylic acid, that's for antifungal and candida, DHA for brain and eyes. Ambertose is a good glycolutrition. Joints. All this stuff is really good.
What is glycolutrition?
It helps with the sugar and just kind of making things easier to
sit in. When I say that, I've been someone who's diabetic.
Yes.
Yes. Cinnamon.
Yes.
Cinnamon's good for that.
Right, cinnamon.
Cinnamon.
Yes. Garlic is good for what ails you. Niacin, which is good for you. It's a good vitamin B. Okay, so we did that. Now do we need a break? Does anybody want a cookie?
You need to take the cherry.
Yes, sir, you do.
I had it the other day because I had diabetes.
Yes.
What juice?
Cherry juice. Is it tart cherry? Yes, tart cherry.
Absolutely.
Okay, I need these back
because
I go with
the...
No, unless you've written on them. And then... Oh, that's fine. Okay. And let me see. Okay. Y'all don't need these. Okay. Did you write them down? Okay, because you can supplement. I'm not a big fan of going to the health food store and buying
86
things. You just need
to... Hey,
oh, good. Beets. Excellent.
Yeah.
What's it for you?
You say you raised on the farm or live on the farm?
I was raised on the farm. I live in the country now, but I don't live on the farm.
So. I was raised on the farm. My wife had many years of raising on the
farm. How many people were raised on the farm?
I've lived. I was young.
Yes, raised.
That's raised.
How many people are city dwellers?
I used to be, so
I
used
here.
You got here? Now you're on the farm.
She's from Hollister.
Oh.
Yeah, I grew up in Hollister. Mm-hmm. Yeah, about 8 miles out of town.
Isn't that close to one here?
Right, just right next door. Okay, so how much time do we have?
More time. Oh my gosh.
Okay, so I'm going to let y'all put the little things back in the little holes. And then I want y'all to stand up because I just can't see y'all sitting here. If you need to stand up.
I don't have to go for long because it's nearly an hour for me to get home, so I need to not keep staying there.
Okay. I have one more thing I need to show you.
Oh, okay.
Right after this. Okay.
It's an hour for you too.
Yeah. Okay, so yeah,
when I get home, just get in with a flashlight.
A little bit bobbles down.
I'm just doing it on the back. I guess I should be doing it on my hand or arm or something so I can see better. But I can just put your arm up there. And put this right here. Right here. It's really small. It's for parasites. Parasites manifest in like really unusual ways. Like, you can help me. Bad sleeping. If you have problems sleeping, especially right around the full moon. You probably don't notice that, but okay. Problems sometimes in your gut. Parasites just wreak havoc over your whole entire body. So a little bit of black walnut, they all gotta go away. Drink lots of water, and you'll feel better. Believe me. And that's a consistent problem in East Texas because we have cows and horses. And if you do that, when you deworm the cows and the cat and the dog, you make sure you deworm you. Okay. This is immune system, and it's, I think this is the one that's kind of an overall immune system. It's just kind of builds you up, a builder, any kind of, I don't even remember what's in that combination, so sorry about that. Let's see if we can get this one.
Or kombucha?
No, just bucha?
Nope.
You know, when you start having like thousands and thousands of things, you remember.
I've never heard of it.
Cranberry, of course, is just for urinary and stuff. Okay, that might help. And bucha, I'm not sure. I'm sorry I can't remember what it is, but you might look it up. Or Google.
B-U-C-H-A?
Bucha. Okay. So that would be like one of the things I would probably put you on a program to take care of some of those problems that you might be having. Okay, now, Lynn, you have to drive how long?
About an hour, nearly an hour.
An hour. Okay.
I will see you soon.
I know.
So,
thank you.
We're going to do one more commercial.
Thank you all for having me. Nice meeting you. Come again. Thank you.
Last commercial is a super duper thing that I like to call light and love. Anything that brings you happiness, that people give you as a present, as something endearing. My friend made me this. He's Buddhist, and he said a prayer for each one of these knots. Each one of the colors is a different prayer group. And he gave this to me. And I believe it holds a lot of power. And because it was made out of love. And so I think those things that we hold dear to us, it might be your cat, it might be that little thing that your daughter gave you a long time ago. Those things are actually here to help you also heal. And what I do when I get a little pain is I just put this, it's like a little compress, and I might just put it right there, It helps me. And of all, I have probably 200 modalities of things that have come to the Healing Center to help heal people. And things like this are just amazing. Because this can give you the same relief as the little white box for arthritis. Any of my big machines, it's the love that really helps.
It's my cat.
Huh?
It's my cat.
Yes. It's the endearing things that love you and you love them that connect you. Now, I'm just going to make a couple of more things. We've talked about body level testing a lot, but I want to talk to you about mental emotional, that you can test things mentally emotionally. Like, I'm feeling a little down. What can I do to make myself feel better? My cat will usually just pops up in your lap and says, I love you. But observing a flower. And you can also say, you know, you can test these things. Will this help me feel better about myself or a better? No. Probably a lot of them would, but anyway, emotionally. Now, spiritually, what you can do is you can find your value system. And what I do a lot is sometimes I open the Bible and I ask in the index page, is there something that I need to read from the Bible? And I go down and I can muscle test what needs to be there. And I find maybe I need to read in Psalms or Proverbs. And so I flip over there and find the scripture. All of those things have energy. So that you can not only heal yourself body level, emotional, mental, but also in a spiritual form. But all these things God has given us to help us and to heal us and for us to be the happiest that we can be. Okay. I'm done.
You're